Welcome back, 6:15 right now. Today's inspiring story will put you in the Christmas spirit.
It's never too early for Christmas. One College of Charleston graduate founded an organization that started with delivering presents to kids in Title I schools. News 2's Ashley Yost shares her story and how she started Charleston Hope.
If you hadn't been willing to help us, some of us wouldn't have toys.
Emily Hoisington's heart broke when she heard these stories.
My sister worked at a Title I school. A lot of her students not only weren't going to receive Christmas gifts that year, really they didn't have the basic necessities they needed in order to learn.
So she and her friends bought gifts for 40 kids. The next year was her first at the College of Charleston.
That year we founded Charleston Hope. I didn't want to be in the schools just at Christmas time.
They also do a day of service.
So we're painting murals, we're cleaning closets to teach that there is poverty in our community and we can do something about it.
And recently started a mentorship program.
We saw a 20% increase of the amount of students on target.
All this success didn't come without struggles. In 2014, tragedy struck.
Our team was really broken.
Emily's boyfriend died suddenly just 1 week after their big Christmas event.
And Chad was a big supporter of Charleston Hope, of my dreams.
Many donations were made in Chad's honor. They started using the hashtag Chad Effect.
We wanted people to know that the reason Chad acted in the intentional ways that he did was because of his relationship with Christ. Not only in serving with a nonprofit or serving at your church, but serving in your day-to-day life. And so we really try to teach that with our students.
And they teach that lesson most tangibly at Christmas time.
It's pure joy that you don't really realize that a single toy, and it is the toy that brings them joy, but immediately they get up and hug the person who gave it to them. I firmly believe they understand that it's not about the toy. Like, we're here to love them, and they want to receive that love, and they want to give it right back.
And they're gearing up for their fundraiser at the end of April. Wednesday, April 26th, is going to be at Lagunitas.
And there are a ton of ways people can help Charleston Hope, right, Ashley?
There are. You can donate your time. You can become a classroom mentor. You can volunteer at their events. You can donate supplies. And then, of course, you can adopt a classroom or donate financially for their big Christmas giving event. Last year, they spread to other cities, not just Charleston. Guys, just about 5,000 kids received gifts because of Charleston Hope here, Akron, Ohio, and another city in South Carolina. Yeah.
Well done.
Pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Well done, CFC.
I know. These are some amazing graduates.
All right. Thank you, Ashley.